This film is not for everyone, especially in India, where we are not used to having a protagonist who's a bad guy. And the success of the film is that it makes you root for this bad guy, which makes us uncomfortable. Why is that? Let's talk about it. Hello guys, I'm Nona Prince, and today we're talking about the Malayalam film Mukundan Unni Associates. I actually watched the film live with other viewers on my second channel, Nona Prince Reacts. It's still up there, you can check it out. And I actually got to know a lot of details about the film and what happened behind the scenes. Now, why I say it's not for everyone is that in the Indian society, we have some beliefs and ideals. There is a desire to be a good guy, to be noble, because that's what we have grown up with. You know, the self-sacrifice person. Because we have seen these qualities in our heroes, in our gods. Because no matter what odds, they stick to their principles. But our protagonist here, Mukundan Unni, is totally opposite of that. He is not at all a hero. He is the villain who at the end actually wins. He's a narcissist, he's an egoist, he's chauvinist, he's sadistic, megalomaniac. Played wonderfully by Vinit Srinivasan, just with his straight face throughout. There was a certain peace and happiness in his body language that was creepy, which just helped to make this character demonic. And we see that gradually happening through the film. We see him in his full white clothes, and the first time he takes it a bit far, there are blood stains on his uniform. We see that he's literally keeping a snake in his house. And there's a saying in Hindi, apne ghar mein saap palna. It is a symbol of betrayal, changing of the aspect ratio, talking about how much control he's gaining through the film. And I like that he's not successful instantly, because we start that he feels he's not successful yet. He keeps changing his age, and as he finds a new way to be successful, he's not good at it from the first attempt. No, it takes him multiple tries. Then he finally gets success, then again he fails, and then there's a constant struggle for it until the end where he finally makes it. And my favorite thing in the film, which I think gives the soul to the character, is the inner monologue, because it just adds the context to the demonic phase. And I learned that they added the inner monologues during the editing. It wasn't the plan like that before. They were gonna keep it silent. And I feel that was a great decision, because it just pushes his character further. You think he's a bad guy, but those dialogues just make him worse. Whenever we think now he may do the right thing, no, he does the worst. And the film is also talking about the whole hustle culture. You know, he has been doing everything to be successful. He has discipline, he has perseverance, he's dedicated, he's passionate. It's 100 on 100 on everything, but still he's not getting any results. And then he just takes it too far. And that actually reminds me of Ravan. He was a great sage. He accomplished everything that he got a Vardhan from Lord Shiva. But again, he also took it too far. But the difference is, Ravan at the end fell. But here, the villain, who's the protagonist of the film, doesn't. He's the winner at the end. And there's no saving grace at all, which is unacceptable. Because there are anti-heroes, you know. They do the wrong things, but at the end of the day, there is some saving grace. Even Rocky Bhai did so many bad things, but at the end of the day, he helped people. He fought for them. He empowered them. But here, there's none. There's actually no karma fighting back. And that's the truth of the society. The corrupt wins, the honest struggles. But most people go to watch films to escape that reality. We all know that reality, but at least in our films, we want to see the good people win. At least in the film, we want to stick to the ideals, which we don't in the real life. And because this film shatters that thin line between real and real, it makes people uncomfortable. The film is so negative, it's showing wrong things, it's teaching wrong stuff, etc., etc. You know, if someone looks up to Mukundan Unni's character, he appeals to them. That means we have failed as a society. Now, there are a lot of comparisons of this film to Nightcrawler, the Hollywood film with Jake Gyllenhaal. And even I watched that film long time ago. So for me, if I had seen this film first, I would have been mind blown. But just because I've seen a similar story unfold where our protagonist is the wrong guy and taking things too far, even winning at the end, I'm not taken aback by it. But you have to give it to the writing. And more than that, I think the film is made by the director, Abhinav Sundar Nayak. You can see his vision. You can see he's in full control of what's happening on screen. All the strings are in his hand and he's playing with them. You know, from the framing to the aspect ratio that keeps changing throughout, the music, the sound design, the editing, all of it is creative. It's challenging the norms. And you can see that from the first frame itself. Every film needs to have a no smoking card in front of it. You can just do it how everyone does it and then start the movie. But no, you are using your creativity even in that and treating it in the same way as the film itself. You are giving your 110%, and as an audience, you feel like it's worth your money and time. You know, there's so much to talk about in this film that this video is not enough. What do you think? Let me know in the comments, should we do a live stream or not? Now, interesting. interestingly, in the award function we did recently, you can check it out here, this film was not nominated for the best film, but it was for one award, which it won. To find out, definitely check this out next. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, and I'll see you next time.